Hello Aquarius, how are you guys doing? Welcome into your July 2021 reading. We're going to be breaking this reading down into four different sections, which is going to indicate the four different weeks. So let's begin. Let's clear the space of any previous readings that I've done, any energies that have been around on the table, and then call in your energy, please, to come in and your spirit guides to please guide the reading as we go forward. So let's get the 4 weeks out. Let's get the 4 weeks energy out for you guys, and then have a look and see what's going to be unfolding on a week-to-week basis throughout July. You can even save this reading, by the way, and come back every week and just check, like, you know, check where you've been and what is going on as you go ahead through the month. It can even help you, you know, maybe give you a bit of a heads up about something coming in, how you can handle it. Otherwise, let's get started, guys. Week one, week two. Ooh, we've got some cards, too many, but that one's sticking out. Let's see. And this one. By the way, guys, my readings, my personal readings, are marked down until the end of June. This reading should come out a day or two before the end of June. If you still want to book a reading with me, you can. Even though the readings will fall over into July, they still qualify as long as they're booked before the end of June. Check the link in the description box below of the video. Let's get into this. Let's have a look and see. You've got a page of pentacles, page of materials energy coming up in the first week from the 1st until the 7th of July. There is definitely something new coming in here. This can be work related for some of you guys. It can be possibly a beginning of a new job, or a sort of like, if you've been trying to look for work, or you've been looking around seeing your CV, that's a very positive start of something. It can also be the beginning of a relationship. That's pentacles energy, which is nice because it indicates some serious energy coming through here. A person that is maybe talking to you, if it is a person, I pick them up as being quite serious person. They're not the life and soul, the joker of the party. They're talking about what's in this card, the Ten of Pentacles. I feel like it's a very serious person. They want this energy. They want to have the Ten of Pentacles. I feel like you guys are communicating with each other. I do feel like for some of you, you're meeting a complete new person. The main theme of your guys' conversation is basically not only about them, but I feel like that when they talk to you about their life or what it is they feel is important, it is the Ten of Pentacles. They do feel like security is important. They may be telling you that they don't have this. It's almost like I feel like there's a very stable person's energy. They may already have the Ten of Pentacles, but there's something off about it. I feel like they've worked their whole life. They've built up almost like this good, stable, like, environment for themselves, but there's something missing. It's not the perfect Ten of Pentacles because it's in the reverse position. It's almost like I feel like somebody talking to you and saying, yeah, you know, I've studied so hard. I ran my own business. I did this, but I never got married. I never had kids. And that's always what I wanted. Or if I did get married, I did have kids. It didn't work out. And it's not what I wanted. I always wanted to have that. So let's have a look and see. Yeah, they definitely, the first week, I feel like you're getting to know somebody. Got the Nine of Pentacles. Yeah, I feel like somebody's talking to you. Somebody's talking to you and they're telling you what happened to them. With the Nine of Pentacles, it's almost like they were dealing with a person that could have even been just after them for stuff like the money and the lifestyle. Because you see the Nine of Pentacles in the reverse position, it can indicate sometimes a bit of a gold digger vibe coming through there. A person who's really just after the Nine of Pentacles, the Ten of Pentacles. And they're not really doing it for the best of reasons. I feel like you're going to get to know somebody. They're going to tell you a bit of their history here. This is quite interesting. Somebody opening up to you like that. Wow, they really connect with you. So let's see into week two from the 8th until the 14th. This is good. You got a Six of Swords voices energy here. This is a new person coming in here, and you're making them feel something. Wow, Aquarius. You're making them feel the Six of Voices. Six of Voices is Six of Swords energy, and it's almost like them talking to you or them expressing their emotions like this. It's causing them to kind of like let this go. Oh, this is beautiful. I don't know if you know what you're doing here, but it's almost like you're being a healer to this person. It's like just listening without even trying to advise them or trying to tell them what to do. Just for them to speak what they have to say. It's like a healing process for them. This is beautiful. I don't know if you know you're doing that. Like, wow. Let's have a look and see what else comes through here. The Queen of Wands, I feel like they're talking to you about somebody in their world. The Queen of Wands, it kind of is this Nine of Pentacles over here. It's this vibe of male or female energy, by the way. It's this vibe of an untrustworthy person. They've got the fear still attached to them, but they might meet somebody. They're very scared that they'll get up in the same situation that they have been in. And I think this is why they're telling you these things. It's like they're letting you know, if we kind of go forward, I don't want to repeat something like this again. I don't want to be involved with somebody who doesn't care about me. They're just using me in some kind of way. So let's see what comes up here. Six of Wands. Yeah, this person is very established. Hey, they're definitely looking. You got two sixes coming in here. This connection that they had could have ended a couple of years ago, could have even been years ago, that they really got burned and they didn't come back, and even indicate 6 months ago. But I kind of got the vibe it's quite a way back. They've been single for quite some time. That's my energy that I'm picking up on here. This person, I don't know who they are, but they really established very well in life. The Six of Wands, they can even be well-known. A well-known person. It's like people know them. They're like, oh, we know that person. This could be this person. It's quite a surprise, hey? Like, not that they're talking to you, but that they open up to you like this. That's how I'm feeling. Who is this person? My goodness. Let's have a look into the third week, 15th to the 21st. I mean, this can even be like an owner of a business, somebody even more than that, somebody who's received awards for different things, like professors or something. It's very interesting energy coming through. I mean, what is this? Like, geez. Let's have a look and see. Two of Materials, energy into your third week from your 15th to the 21st. Decisions need to get made. I kind of picking up a lot on the person's energy coming into your reading. This person's, the energy that they carry, I feel like it's almost like their spirit guides have come forward more than yours, okay? And it's like this person's energy is being pushed into the reading. They are going to make decisions with regards to you with the Two of Pentacles. This is not even like a July reading. This sounds like a what are they thinking reading or what are they feeling reading. Sorry about that. It's nothing I can do with the cards that come up here, but I kind of feel like they're making decisions about releasing what no longer serves them with the Two of Materials being there. They're getting to know you as well. Slowly they're getting to know you, they're getting to trust you, and as they get to trust you, they're going to sort of like let you in more and more. Let's see what comes in here. There you go, Seven of Pentacles. This person is planning. That's my cat being naughty. What are you doing? Sorry, she's just like wanting my attention. With the Seven of Pentacles being here, I do feel that they're planning something long-term here. They're a little bit scared because Seven of Pentacles is in the reverse position. It can indicate that fear that because of what has occurred to them in the past. There is somebody coming in here thinking some very serious things here. And I do kind of like feel they're thinking about the future with you. As they get to know you, they start to release more and more of this energy of the fear. That's why the Six of Swords is there. And as they get to know you, I feel like they're going to be revealed. You're going to reveal more of yourself to them. They like what they see. Look at that. You got your strength card rocking up here. This connection is just going to get stronger and stronger. As you guys move on, as you guys move forward, this connection is growing. The strength card, also Leo's energy coming in here. This is a very good growth that we're looking at here. Let's see what else comes in. The last week, this is moving, guys. From the 22nd to the 31st, action. We got some action coming in here. Shift is going to happen in your guys' connection. If you guys are just talking to each other, you haven't yet gotten to the stage where, yeah, there is definitely more than just friendship happening. Last week of the month. The Knight of Voices energy, once again, very logical, but very quick. There's a very quick shift that happens here. Very, maybe a bit unexpected, but this is going to move forward extremely quickly. And I like the energy of it because it indicates logical thinking. It indicates clear thought, not just diving in head first. As I can see, this person first revealed their past to you, let you know where they're coming from, how they feel, getting to know you very slowly, but it's like, boom, immediate shift. Very interesting reading. Let's have a look and see what else will come in here for you guys. Love is developing. There is some hearts that are beating a bit faster. Yeah, I absolutely knew when I saw that. Yeah, I like this. Just like immediate changing. Baby, what are you trying to do exactly? My cat's being naughty. She just wants my attention. So let's have a look and see what else comes up here for you guys. You see, when our animals distract us in readings, let's see. Got an Ace of Cups in the reverse position. There could be a little bit of timing that is off here. With the Ace of Cups in the reverse position, you might have to take it a bit slow with this person. I feel like they're going to want to take it very slow. It's almost like, yes, things are happening. There's a definite shift from we are friends to there is something going on here. With the Ace of Cups coming in the reverse position, I do feel like it's timing mainly. They're going to want to really take it slow. It's not like they're going to jump head first in. I actually want to get one more card for that Ace of Cups. I want some confirmation from there. They're going to take this very, very slow. That's how I feel. Definitely. There's your Eight of Pentacles energy. This is what I wanted to see. That's actually very good. I wanted to be 100% sure. They want to take it slow. They want to work on it with you. And the Pentacles, once again, Seven of Pentacles, Eight of Pentacles. They want to work on it. They really want to have a connection, a relationship. That's not something that's going to end like now. I don't know what it is that you want there. But my cat is ripping my cupboard open. I don't know why. Maybe there's a toy in there or something that she wants. We're going to see what she's up to. Okay. Sorry, I don't know why she's behaving like this. Let's see. We've got two cards coming up here. Oh, Lordy. This is beautiful, guys. Wow. Literally, the Ace of Cups is in the reverse position. And here it is in the upright position with the Empress. What did I tell you? This person wants to have the Ten of Pentacles with somebody. And that's why they're taking this time to get to know you. We've got the Empress. Beautiful energy coming through here. I'm going to pick her up. Come here. She's running away from me. She's being so naughty. The Empress energy, Archangel Gabriel's energy, lavish abundance. Give birth to your dreams. Possibly, if you haven't had children, this can be a person, even in your future, that you may have a child with. They could be thinking about having children as well. Nurture yourself and others. This is a beautiful thing. This is a relationship. This is literally, the Empress lives in the Ten of Cups, Ten of Pentacles over there, and the Ten of Cups as well. A home, children, life. Just all the beautiful things that we want to have with another person. It is going there. Allow them to take it slow, because look, we do see a future coming in here that's got the upright Ace of Cups. I love it. Look what it says there, falling in love. Okay, there's your King of Cups. I knew there's that energy. Or the resurgence of a relationship. I kind of like feel like it's a very new person. Spiritual growth and enhanced intuition. Ooh, and a new home. There's your Empress, and there's a home. This person may even buy a house with you guys, for you guys in the future. The both of you together may buy a new home with each other. But this is heading to somewhere very stable, very beautiful. Be patient. Allow them to unfold it as they want to. Remember, they're coming from something here that was absolutely nothing that looks like this. They've always wanted to have this Empress. I felt like they were building their life, but what was always missing, what's in this picture, which is literally like the mom holding the baby there. And they've always had this. It's always been missing for them. And they're hoping to find this with you. There we go, Aquarius. I'm sending you my love and light. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.